Hello, I am Olivia Wilson, and my SIT project was a photography showcase, and I wanted to showcase the hidden truths of Louisville. I focused on festivals, events, places, etc., and I really wanted to focus on getting small businesses or new businesses the recognition that they deserve and to help people get involved in the community. I chose this project because one of my biggest passions for as long as I can remember was always photography. I always loved doing it and I always kind of wanted to do it for a living. So this project really helped me elevate that dream. And I have always loved and have always been interested in the city that I live in. So this project helped me venture out and explore the place that I live in and just get to know the community that I grew up in. I also have a website showcasing other works of mine other than this project. On this website, I have also uploaded a few videos on how to edit in different styles using an iPhone. In the future, I hope to upload a lot more onto this, and you can visit this site at oliviawilsonphotos.weebly.com. So I never took any pictures in class. I did that on my own time. But when I was in class, the bulk of my time was spent editing my pictures. That was one of the things that took a lot longer than I anticipated. And through that process, I kind of taught myself how to edit and to use different programs. And I developed my own style of editing. I also spent class time writing history blurbs about most of my events that I went to. So in class, I would research. And then I would write maybe like a paragraph or two on how it got started, how long it's been, that kind of stuff. And then most of the festivals that I went to, I interviewed somebody. So in class, I would write that and type it. I would usually add it into a format, so add some sort of aesthetically pleasing clip art or something of that matter. Also during class, I would do kind of the business standpoint of this project. So if there was any emails I needed to send or anything that I needed to respond to, I would do this during class. And if there was anybody that I needed to get in contact with, so I would call venues, my mentors, that sort of thing. So I'm still going to do a showcase of my work, but now I'm going to do a Instagram and Facebook page. And then I'm going to post like all my pictures, interviews, and the history on each event. And then later in the summer, I'm planning on converting all that information to my website. So one of the biggest obstacles that I have faced during this unfortunate event is not being able to have a actual in-person show. I mean, that's kind of what the whole process was about. That was like my end result. So like I've overcome this by accepting the fact that I can't have one, and that just takes a lot of stress off of me because I try to keep getting in contact with Manhattan on Broadway, which was a place that I was going to originally have it, and it was just so stressful to try to get emails and people to respond back to me. So by me accepting the fact that I'm not going to be able to is one of the biggest things that I've had to overcome. The most important things that SIP has taught me would probably be self-motivation and time management. And here are some of my works.
Try to keep you close to me. But life got in between. Tried to square, not being there, but said that I should have been. Hold back the river, let me look in your eyes. Hold back the river so wide. Stop for a minute and see where you hide. Hold back the river, hold back. One.
now we call against the tide. Those distant days are flashing by.
So if you are interested in joining SIP, you will never regret it. It was one of the best decisions I ever made to show up to the interview. And I hope you have enjoyed my SIP presentation.